In this video, I will talk about final year MBBS study approach. What are the subjects? Basically, we have four subjects: surgery, medicine, pedia, OBGY. Okay, in surgery, ortho is covered, in derma and psyche is covered in medicine. Okay, so what I recommend is to start studying according to your posting. Okay, if you have medicine posting, read medicine. Okay, priority should be medicine. Okay, during that time, mostly the posting will be of 2 months or 2.5 months. Okay, and you need to do both theory part and practical part, and there will be ward living exam. Okay, so what I recommend is first read whatever system you are taking. Okay, first read the theory of that system, then read the practicals. In practical, what you need to read is about examination. So first, in theory, what you will you take the important topics like COPD, asthma, TB. Okay, now read the clinical features, read the diagnosis, and read the treatment. Now you should do the examination part, that how you will examine the patient, how, what history you will ask, okay, how systemic examination is done, how to come to differentials, okay, how to rule out the diseases. In this way, your topic will be cleared and you will understand it better. Okay, and you need to go to your ward. You need and there you need to find the patients, okay, who is having COPD, asthma, TB, whatever case you want to take, and ask them their history, how the disease developed, okay, how it progressed, now what on what treatment they are at, and in this way you should take the history and write the whole history in your notebook, and then go home and correlate it with the theory. This is the best approach that one can follow, okay, to have the concepts clear in your brain. Okay, this will remain in your brain for a long time. Okay, instead of reading, it will take you nowhere. Okay, you need to be very much practical, because final year is all about practicals. Okay, after this you will have your MBBS degree, and some do PGs or some start their clinical practice. So this is the time where you need to give your best, you need to do your 100% to understand the diseases, how to approach them, how to diagnose them, because after this there is no such, like, this is the golden opportunity, I should say. There is no such opportunity, and whatever field you will go take, you will study about that field. Okay, so and in our medicine everything is correlated, so it is very much important to know the, to have the basic knowledge about all these subjects, okay, and how to approach them. At least at this stage we should know where to refer the patient. Okay, we need to guide the patient at this level. People don't expect expertization at this level, but yeah, they do expect you to show them the proper way. So if you do this way, it will be helpful for your exams, for your career, and also for your next exam. Okay, because nowadays I mean, the pattern of the next exam, everybody knows that there is a clinical based exam, that is next part 2. So what they will ask you is this: they will give you the patient, they ask you to diagnose the patient, they will ask you some questions out of it. So if you are start practicing at this point, okay, then it will be very much helpful in long run. Now if you are doing CVS, do the theory part, do the IMP topics. If you want, then I can list the IMP topics. Please tell me in the comment section if you want, and do examination part. Maximum you can give 2 weeks for each system. You need to do this system: RS, CVS, GIT, and CNS. Okay, so stick to your basics. There is no need to read hi-fi stuffs. Okay, you just entered the final year, and your target is to clear MBBS. Okay, you are not gonna to give एनी सुपर स्पेशलिटी एग्जाम दैट यू नीड अ वेरी इन डेप्थ नॉलेज. सो डोंट वरी, जस्ट स्टिक टू योर बेसिक. बेसिक्स शुड बी क्लियर एंड यू आर गुड एट एवरीथिंग यू आर डूइंग. ओके, नाउ वर्ड लिविंग एग्जाम, वॉट दे हाउ दे आर आस्किंग इज दे विल गिव यू द पेशेंट. देर इज़ अ लॉन्ग केस, शॉर्ट केस, इंस्ट्रूमेंट पार्ट. ओके, देर आर टू वाइवर्स ऑन दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड जनरल. दे विल शो यू ईसीजी इन मेडिसिन. ओके, सो इट्स लाइक दैट. सो देर आर फोर स्टेशन यू नीड टू क्लियर. ओके, टेक इट इन दिस वे. सो दे विल गिव यू द पेशेंट, यू नीड टू एग्जामिन द पेशेंट, यू नीड टू राइट द हिस्ट्री. दे विल गिव यू अराउंड 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, it is different everywhere. It depends on the number of students, and you won't be able to get the whole of your 30 minutes. Okay, for the, so be prepared that you take as much as history as possible during your postings. So you will have the good practice. Okay, that you will be able to clear your exams. So yeah, you need to diagnose. Okay, you just need to give differential diagnosis of the diseases. There is no need to give the particular statement, yeah, the patient is having COPD. No, it's not like that. Never give this kind of statement. You should tell that from the above history and examination, my probable diagnosis is this. And my differential diagnosis is whatever is your differential diagnosis. You can say like this. Okay, now when we come to surgery postings, during your postings read your practical books. Now in this, what you need to do is approach is little bit different. Divide your time for the practical and theory. Okay, this much time should be like 75% of the time is for theory, 25% for practical. You need to do this regularly every day for 2 months. Okay, do the IMP topics, do the IMP cases that are asked in your university exams. And instrument part is also important in surgery, because there will be so many instruments and you are required to know the parts of the instrument, where they are used, what are the pros and the cons of that instrument. Okay, so when you are posted in surgery department during your postings, then try to see as many as instruments, try to list the instruments and write, take the photos or make videos on that, and write the uses. So before exam you can just have a look, you can go for the exam. Then in gynec we have Datta and practical apart from the practical books. Okay, in our book we were in our college we were given a Xerox copy of a book. From that only we used to read the practical part. So it is different for every college. You can approach your senior for this, and if you want then I can recommend the book. Please tell me in comment section. So here also you need to do the same approach as surgery. This much time is for the practicals, this much for the theories. Okay, instruments, again instruments are very important. Your viva will start with instrument and it will end with instruments in gynec. You'll experience this. Then pedia, it's easy subject. There is no need for in depth knowledge. But what you require is try to complete whole of PDA's IMP topic. Just do IMP topic. There is no need to read the whole guy. Okay, there are IMP topics. Do read them. First complete those IMP topics and then read whatever you want to read if you have time. Okay, for practicals there is not much to do. Okay, your seniors can guide you better. But if you take the general, there will be it will be mostly overlapped with medicine. There will be a system-wise approach here also. RS, CVS, they will give you any cases. Mostly they will give you GIT case mostly. Okay, then nephrotic syndrome case. You because these are very commonly seen. Then anemia cases. These are the kind of the cases they used to give. Okay, general part is milestones. You need to read the milestones. Okay, it's like a rattama types. You need to just read as many times as you can. Then growth charts, MNCI. Then there are different ways of examining the kids. Okay, like we cannot examine the same way as we do with adults. Okay, so there are different ways to examine the kids. Usually they cry when you when you palpate them, or when you ask them any questions, they start crying. They will not cooperate. So there are different tricks to approach them, examine them. So you need to learn this. This is the skill that will be tested in the exam. So try to take as many cases as possible, okay, and try to console the kids. Try to learn it. So pedigree chart, calorie counting, and age calculation. This both are very volatile topics. So just read it before exam, and you'll be good at this. Now, what are the books you need to read? For medicine, Matthews and Harrison. This is the standard book. If somebody can able to read, then they can read. It's hard to read. I mean, such a big book, and it is at a PG level. So if you are interested, you can just read some topics if you want. But Matthews will be your savior in the exam. To pass the exam, you are required to read this. There is also Davidson, but that is also vast. So you can use this both book as a reference, but this is the savior. Then for practicals, Golwala, SRB surgery, SRB for surgery. Now this is also a big book, PG level book, but people usually read from this because it's easy to grasp topics from this book. And if you are not able to cover this, then you can also read from Manipal. Then for practical, S. Das and Makhanlal, mostly your seniors, I mean your teachers, professors, they will recommend this book. Yeah, this book is good, no doubt, but this is the best for the practicals, okay, I should say, because I have experienced it personally. So if you can, then buy both this book and try to do cases from both this. From Gynec, Vio Datta, and Guy in Pedia, and for Ortho, Maheshwari, and Derma and Psyche, we usually, you can use coaching notes if you joined any, or you can borrow it because that's enough, no need to buy book. And if you want, then tell me in the comment section, I will tell you the books you can have for Derma and Psyche. But I don't recommend to waste your time, okay, by reading those standard books, because there will be big and so many things to remember. So what I recommend is just read the coaching notes, because IMP, they will mainly give you the IMP topics, IMP stuff, so it will be enough for the exams, okay. And yeah, that's all for this video.